Well, they sing, they chant, they cheer, and this Ashes campaign, they're allowed a trumpet player. The Barmy Army has arrived and they're already marching on Brisbane. 10 reporter Jonathan Lee caught up with them.
Well, it wouldn't be the Ashes without the irrepressible Barmy Army, and once again the guys are back. Today they took on the Australian Fanatics 11 to raise money for the McGrath Foundation, and joining me is the co-founder of the Barmy Army. You must be mad, Paul Burnham. Welcome back for another tour.
Good afternoon.
Tell me, what's the mood like in the camp? A little bit smaller than previous years.
It is a bit smaller, but listen, the mood's optimistic. We're really confident we're going to perform well right from the word go this time and take it all the way to Sydney, and let's have a nail biter there, and hopefully England will come out the right side of that one.
Now, you are an army and words are your weapons. I understand a few of the boys have got a couple of chants. Can we hear them?
Absolutely. Listen, there's plenty of new songs, and over to Deco. He's got a new verse here.
Now the pound to the dollar doesn't seem to be fair, but look at our faces, do you think we even care? We've come in our numbers and we're gonna see another famous Ashes victory.
Now, one of the faces you might be familiar with is Bill, the trumpet player. Last time around, 2006 and 7, he was prevented from entering the Gabba. Bill, you must be a bit nervous coming up this weekend.
I'm slightly nervous, but I've been assured this time I'm totally legal and I'm gonna be allowed to play my trumpet and try and inspire the England boys onto a victory.
If these guys are anything to go by, we might be struggling to get the Ashes back.